Hello everyone. Today's lecture is based on Introduction of Recombinant DNA Technology. In today's session, we'll study in detail about host cells and vectors. What are the different types of host cells and what are the different type of vectors involved in recombinant DNA technology? Now, what is host cell and what this host cells are also known as? Factories of cloning. Now, these host cells are living system or cells in which the carrier of recombinant DNA molecule or vector can be propagated. Now, what are the types of host involved here? So, there are two major types of host. The one belongs to the prokaryotic cell, that is bacteria, right? Only the one microorganism or the one organism belongs to the prokaryotic cell. The second is eukaryotic cell. So, here fungi, animals and plants. So, the animals are also human being. We can say the human beings also can take a part in a recombinant DNA technology. Mostly we used to go for the mammalian cells, the nothing but the mouse cell. Now, what are the characteristics of this prokaryotic host? Now, why we preferred microorganisms as a host? So, they multiply faster as compared to the cells of higher organism. That's why we preferably go for the prokaryotic host. As the bacteria multiplies, their plasmids along with the foreign DNA also multiply to produce millions of copies referred to as a colony or in short clone, right? And the term clone is broadly used to a mass of cells, organisms or genes that are produced by multiplication of a single cell, organism or gene. So this is the reason why we prefer the prokaryotic host. The second is eukaryotic organism. So this is preferred when we have to produce a complex protein. Ultimately, by utilizing a bacteria, we cannot produce the complex protein, which is required for the human, right? So that is the reason that prefer to produce human protein, since this host with a complex structure, with a distinct organelles, and are more suitable to synthesize complex protein. Now, what are these eukaryotic organisms involved in this recombinant DNA technology? So the one is a yeast, specifically Saccharomyces cerevisiae is used here. The second one is a mammalian cells. So in mammalian cells, again, mouse cells are more preferential. Again, these cells are possess a machinery to modify a protein and it is to its final form. And that is the reason it is used in a post-translational modification. So it is possible in case of human gene only, right? Or human, if we go for the human cell or eukaryotic cell, then only it is possible to get the post-translational modifications. The example is tissue plasminogen activator. Again, the gene manipulation experiments in higher animal and plants are usually carried out to alter the genetic makeup of the organism to create transgenic animal or transgenic plant. So the example that is tobacco mosaic plant is an example of transgenic plants. So these are the eukaryotic host cells we preferably use for the factories of cloning, right? Now the next one is, these are the different examples and group of host cells involved in recombinant DNA technology. So you can see the prokaryotic bacteria, Escherichia coli, which we used to use in our laboratory also. This is preferred but cannot perform post-translational modifications. Although this Escherichia coli can replicate within 20 minutes. I'm repeating it, it used to get replicate within 20 minutes. 20 minutes mein iska replication ho jata hai, but it is having a limitation. It do not perform the post-translational modification. And that's why the limitation is there while producing the complex protein. The second example is Bacillus subtilis. The third one is Streptomyces. Now eukaryotic host, fungi, Saccharomyces cerevisiae, Aspergillus, Nidulans. Now in case of animals, insect cells, oocytes, mammalian cells. Which mammalian cells I have discussed? Yes, you can put your answer in a chat. Yeah, which mammalian cell I have discussed? Just post your answer. Very good. So that is mouse cell that we preferably use, right? The next one is whole organism. So we can use a whole organism for the recombinant DNA technology, and the plants, protoplast, intact cells, and whole plants. Now, what are the, this, we have seen all about the host cells. Now, which vectors, like this vectors are nothing but the cloning vehicles, which used for this cloning purpose. So this vectors are the DNA molecules which can carry a foreign DNA fragment to be cloned. So it is carrying a particular DNA fragment, not a whole DNA, right? It is just carrying a particular fragment of DNA, jisko clone karna hai, jiska cloning karna hai. Now the next, this vectors are self-replicating in an appropriate host cell. Host cell mein wo khud se hi replicate ho raha hai. Now, what are the different types of vectors? So there are four types of vectors: plasmids, bacteriophages, cosmids, and phasmids. So these four are the types of vectors. Now, what are the ideal characteristics of vector? So it should be a small in size with a single restriction endonuclease site and origin of replication, and 1 to 2 genetic markers to identify the recipient cells carrying vector. And naturally occurring plasmids are rarely possess this characteristics, right? So this is what all about the vectors. Now we'll see the first one, that is plasmid. I think you understood the characteristics of ideal vectors, right? So it should be a small with a single restriction nuclease size, yani single q, kyunki wo ek hi jagah se cut hoga, and 1 to 2 genetic markers jisse pata chalega, so that recipient cells kaun sa wo carry kar raha hai. Now this is generally observed in case of artificial vectors. Naturally occurring plasmids jo hai, they rarely possess this characteristics. Now what is plasmid, right? This is not the first time we are studying plasmid. We have studied it earlier also. You can post your answers in a chat. What is plasmid? Yes, what is plasmid? Yes, you can post your answer. Bhumija, Uday, Umer, Abhishek. Nobody? Plasmids is an extracellular DNA, right? Yes, it is a vector. Very good. Recently, we have studied it as a vector. Extra chromosomal double stranded DNA, self replicating DNA, small extracellular. Yes, very good. This is all indicates you are still like alive and doing study also. Very good, very good. So plasmids are nothing but the extra chromosomal double stranded circular self replicating DNA molecule, right? All bacteria contains this plasmid, not specifically E. coli. Every bacteria consisting of this plasmid, which copy number 1 to 4 per cell, or a high copy number, it might be 10 to 100 per cell, right? So it can vary with the bacteria to bacteria, right? The next is the size of the plasmid varies from. Plasmid is specifically present in, we are talking about the bacteria, that is prokaryotic cell, right? So it is not present in eukaryotic cell, it is present in the prokaryotic cell. Understood? Now the bacteria, the size of plasmid varies from 1 to 15 kb, that is kilobytes. This is again the unit. Then usually plasmids contribute to about 0.5 to 5% of a total DNA of bacteria. So definitely it is contributing a 1/4, what we can say, the weight of or part of DNA of bacteria, not a complete mass of bacteria, DNA of bacteria. Understood? So this is what about the plasmid. Now what are the different types of plasmid? This is again a question for all of you. Yes, you understood. It is from the prokaryotic cell only. Yes, what are the types of plasmid? Conjugative and non-conjugative, very good. F plasmid, Harsha, very good. Again, which one I discussed more? R plasmid, very good. That is resistant plasmid, right? So anybody else with the other answer? Coal plasmid, very good. Yes. Yeah. Any other answer? No. Virulence plasmid, fine. Good. This virulence plasmid, yes, very, very good. Radha, that is stringent and relaxed. It indicates that you have gone through the biotechnology book and you have studied it also. Very good, very good. So these are all the different types of Uday, Himani, non-integrating plasmid, fine. Okay, fine. So this is what all about the different types of plasmid. So now what are the actual different types of plasmid here? So it is classified on the based of transfer gene, like the one which is carrying the transfer gene. The particular bacteria or the particular organism it is, or the one which is carrying the transfer gene, these are called as conjugative and non-conjugative. So based on the carrying the transfer gene, so they are classified into conjugative and non-conjugative. Now conjugative are the larger one and stringent control of DNA replication. They have a stringent control on DNA replication and they are in a low number, right? Now the second is non-conjugative. It is again based on the transfer gene. These are smaller one, relaxed control of DNA replication and high number, right? So these are the two types of plasmids classified on the basis of the transfer gene. The second one is based on copy number. Like copy number means how many that particular cells are copying. So they are stringent and relaxed plasmid. So the stringent plasmids are 1 to 2 per cell and relaxed plasmids are large number for each cell, right? And the next one is F plasmid, where the genes for their own transfer from one cell to the another. So these are the one which carries the we can say that the E. coli specifically carrying this F plasmid, so genes for their own transfer from one cell to the another cell. The second one is the R plasmid, that is resistant plasmid. So these are the genes resistant to antibiotics. Now you can see this is the diagrammatic presentation indicates this is the example of the particular one. It is labeled there. The particular plasmid is having a different areas over that you can see the origin of replication. Yahan se replicate ho raha hai. It is carrying the ampicillin resistant gene. You can see the ECRI. This is the which type of restriction under nuclease it is. This E. coli RI. Which type of restriction under nuclease it is? Very good, yes. It is a second type of restriction endonucleases, right? So this is cutting this particular one at particular fragment. Now you can see that BAM HI, this is one more we can say plasmid. This is particularly for tetracycline resistant, and the SALI, these are the two different what we can say the plasmids associated with the tetracycline resistant. So this is the example of plasmid which is carrying a different resistant gene with it. Understood? So this is the one example we can say associated with the all plasmid. Now the next one is Bacteriophages. Now, what is the bacteriophages? Again, this is the question. What are bacteriophages? I expect other people also will going to answer. Degradative. Okay. Didn't know the diagram. Okay, fine. It is a diagram of a particular plasmid. It is labeled as I think P361. This is a name of actual plasmid. Yes. Okay. Bacteriophage is a virus that replicate in bacteria. Okay. Virus containing bacteria. They infect bacteria. Bacteria which infect. No. Not at all. Gracie, bacteria which infects virus nahi hoga. Virus can infect the bacteria. Bacteria ko virus infect karega. Virus ko bacteria infect nahi kar sakta hai. Okay. Helical structure, very good. So these are the different characteristics of this bacteriophage. So exactly, bacteriophages are viruses which infects the bacteria. Yes, Himanshu, virus infects the bacteria. A virus which parasitized a bacteria. Ultimately, kyunki it is a obligate parasite. Virus is an obligate parasite. Okay. Yes. Use as a cloning vector. Very good. A typical famous example of virus which infects the bacteria. Which one? Okay, fine. Bacteriophage itself. It is a class actually. The examples are different. Fine. So this is what all about the bacteriophage. It is the phages are viruses that replicates within the bacteria. Okay. Phage vectors can accept short fragments of foreign DNA into their genome, can take up larger DNA segments than plasmid. Now, bacteriophages, why we are taking it as a vector? Because this is the infected bacteria, na, if we consider. But we are taking it into the consideration. The reason behind this is it is having a DNA segment larger than that of the plasmid. Plasmid ki jo DNA segment hai, usse badi iski DNA segment hai. And it preferred for working with genomes of human cell. So it is preferred for working with the human cells. Now, what are the different types of bacteriophages, right? So that the bacteriophage lambda is there, which we have seen most of the time. Insertion vectors are there, replacement vectors are there, phage M13 vectors are there. This phage M13 vectors are useful for the sequencing DNA through a Sanger's method. So it is not in detail for you, but just remember this phage M13 vector is used for the sequencing of DNA through a Sanger's method. So this is what all about the bacteriophages. Now, how this bacteriophages are involved in the cycle? So you are quite aware about the lytic cycle and lysogenic cycle. We have already studied this in the virus, if you can recall at some extent. So you can see this is the bacteriophage. This bacteriophage is with the capsid, right? So the upper one protein is the COS protein, which is there in the, yes, it is a T2, Abhishek, right? So this is the T2. Bacteriophage, it is having a head. DNA, this is the DNA, it is with the bacteriophage. Again, this is the COS protein. This is the tail and this is the tail fiber. So when this particular bacteriophage infects the other organism or bacteria, so either it goes to the lytic cycle or it goes to the lysogenic cycle. So in this case, you can see at one side where the particular DNA fragment comes inside the bacterial cell, we can consider it as an E. coli, and it turns to a circular DNA, right? It is with the COS protein. It goes to the replication and further it goes to the cleavage, and it is producing two separate DNA fragments which further get encapsulated under the capsid, and after lysis it will get go outside the host or that particular organism. Right, so this is the lytic cycle. Now, what is lysogenic cycle? Here, that circular DNA get combined with the Escherichia coli chromosome, right? So this organism is Escherichia coli. The circular DNA get combined with this Escherichia coli chromosome, and further excision integration is there. This, it will going to form a intermediate one, and then further it goes to the replication. So after replication, either it goes to the lytic cycle or again it will go to the lysogenic cycle. So these are the two major cycles of bacteriophages. So how it going to produce that particular more DNA, so which that particular one is associated with the particular protein, right? Now the next one is cosmid. So you have seen it first time. So now what is cosmid? So it is possessing the characteristics of both plasmid and bacteriophage lambda, right? So it is one जो दोनों के characteristics use करता है. Use as a loaning vector, contains a lambda phage. Okay, yes. Constructed by adding a fragment of phage lambda DNA including cos cyto to plasmid. So it is constructed by adding a fragment of phage lambda DNA including cos cyto to plasmid, right? So यहाँ पे दोनों के characteristics ये possess कर show कर रहा है इधर plasmid के भी और bacteriophage के भी. Now a foreign DNA about 40 then can be inserted into the cosmid. हम foreign DNA को cosmid में insert कर सकते हैं. The recombinant DNA so formed can be packed as a phages and injected into Escherichia coli. Inside the host cell, cosmids behave just like a plasmids and replicates. Host के body में जाने के बाद it will behave like a plasmids and replicate. So it carry a larger fragments of foreign DNA compared to the plasmid. And why we used to go for cosmid also? क्योंकि ये भी larger fragment carry कर रहा है foreign DNA की in comparison with the plasmid. So you can see this one. So the first one that is cosmid. So it is with the cos site, right? And another one is foreign DNA. So with the help of restriction endonucleases, which is DNA cutting enzyme, it is cutting that particular fragment, right? So it is also cutting this foreign DNA in a particular parts. This cutted DNA fragment get combined with the DNA ligase, that is joining will occur. After joining, that packaging in vitro means we are inserting this particular to the phage. Now this phage is carrying cos ends also and 50 kb DNA also, right? So it is cos also and plasmid also. Now this is the phage lambda. It inject like this phage infects the other other bacteria or other we can say organism. So it infect the Escherichia coli. So here it transfers the plasmid form of cosmid. So this is nothing but the plasmid form. क्यों? क्योंकि हमने कहा कि cosmid जब enter कर रहा है, उसके बाद वो plasmid जैसा behave कर रहा है. Understood? जब initially it is a cosmid, it shows the characteristic of plasmid और bacteriophage दोनों की characteristic दिखाएगा. जब वो phage के अंदर चले गया, जब वो organism के अंदर चले गया, उसके बाद replicate होगा as a plasmid. And that's why you can see this fragment is nothing but the plasmid form of cosmid. I think you understood. And further it goes to the replication. And this will going to produce the required gene or protein. Yes. So this is what about. As we have seen plasmids, bacteriophages earlier. Now the next one is phasmid. Now what is this phasmid? Phasmid is a combination of plasmid and phage. So it can function as either one. It can function as a plasmid or phage, not both. So this is phasmid vector. Now the another type of vectors, these are artificial chromosome vectors. This means that these are we prepared in a lab. So it depends or it get vary with the different type of host we have used. So the first one is human artificial chromosome. Yes, we can prepare the human artificial chromosome. It is labeled as HAC. So it is 1/10 to 1/5 of the human chromosome. Now the second one is yeast artificial chromosome. It is having a largest capacity of the vector in comparison with the natural vectors. Then the third one is bacterial artificial chromosome. So it is labeled as BAC. So these are the all artificial chromosomes and resembles to all the characteristics of vectors. And the third one is, or we can say the last one is shuttle vectors. So that, what do you mean by shuttle? Yes, it is as we used to play a badminton. So the shuttle is there. So shuttle used to be in one court or in other court. So it replicates in two different host, right? So the origin of replication for two hosts are combined in one plasmid. Therefore, any foreign DNA fragment introduced into a vector can be expressed in either host. It can be expressed in any one host, but not in both, right? So it can be grow in one host and then shifted to another host. That is the reason we used to call it as a shuttle. So it is growing in a one host and shifting to the another host. So good number of eukaryotic vectors are the shuttle vectors. So this is what all about the vectors, vehicles used in the recombinant DNA technology. So in next session, we'll study methods of gene transfer and gene cloning strategies. Reference the same Satya Narayan, Genetic Engineering, Biotechnology book. Thank you so much.